In today's video, I'm going to be going through the A to Z of planning and booking your first cruise. So let's get started. Hi there, I'm Elana from the website and blog Life Well Cruised, where we help thousands of people a month get ready for their cruise with our cruise travel tips. Now, today what I wanted to do was talk to you about the 10 tips that you'll need to know for planning and booking your first cruise. So before we get started, I did just want to mention to you that if you do like this video, please do give it a thumbs up. It really helps me to know that you like this content and that I should create more content like this. And of course, it also helps my channel to grow, and I do appreciate that. Now, of course, if you do like this video and if you enjoy cruise content like this, cruise vlogs and cruise tips, then please consider subscribing to the channel. So now let's get started on those tips on how to book and plan your first cruise. So if you're planning a cruise, especially if it's the first time that you're planning a cruise, you might have quite a lot of questions about where to get started. So the first thing that we're going to do is really go through this kind of step by step. And the first thing that you'll want to think about is what type of cruise vacation do you want? So what I mean by this is think about if you want something more relaxing, because different cruise ships will provide you that experience. Or do you want something with a lot of activities on board and a lot of entertainment aspects? So those are two really kind of different cruise experiences that you can have, and that will really impact the type of vacation. And the second thing that you'll want to think about is the type of itinerary. What type of destinations would you like to see? Do you prefer to do a beach vacation, in which case maybe a Caribbean cruise will be ideal for you, or Bahamas or Bermuda, somewhere that's really warm? Or is the purpose of your vacation to see culture and travel experiences that have history involved, like something in the Mediterranean, or perhaps visiting the Baltic area? There are so many different choices, including even a bucket list trip, including Alaska, South America, or more. So the first thing you'll want to do when planning a cruise is think about destination and the type of cruise ship experience that you want. And the third thing is your budget. But we will come back to that later, because it is important first that we establish the type of vacation that you want. Number two. So the second thing that you'll want to look at is the cruise ship itself. So once you've established the type of vacation you want, the destination that is ideal, after that, what we're going to do is look at the cruise ships that are available and the cruise lines, but the cruise ships themselves that are available that combine those two things. Now, just to give you a bit of an idea, for instance, if you really like a very active vacation and you were looking at maybe a cruise line that tends to have a lot more activity, that they at least advertise a little bit more and market a little bit more, such as Norwegian Cruise Line or Royal Caribbean Cruise Line, those would be great choices for that type of vacation. But you would want to look at the cruise ship itself to also make sure that it has the amenities on board that you'll really like. Every cruise line has smaller ships and has larger ships, and they both really offer something great in terms of a cruise experience, but they are a different experience. So that's when we'll want to narrow down the cruise ship that goes to the itinerary that you want, and as well that it is the amenities on the ship that you like. And you might have a couple of choices even at that point, but that'll help you to start narrowing that down. Number three. So the third thing that we can now look at are your dates to travel. So every cruise itinerary actually has dates that they are traveling. The Caribbean, for instance, does actually go year round, but even somewhere like the Caribbean does have times where there are many more ships in the area and does have times where there are a little bit less choices. Generally, that would be in the summer months, where the cruise ships leave some of them the Caribbean to go to different places, but not necessarily confined to that. And it does change from year to year. So always look back to see what is available. And a little hint is that when you have a cruise season, for instance, Alaska and other itineraries as well, but when you have a region like that, you'll have the shoulder seasons. So a little tip is that if the season is from April till October, for instance, is that beginning of the season and that end of the season can really have sometimes the very best values as well. Number four, planning for your budget. So let's go into a couple of things that go into the budget for your cruise. So one of the things is going to be the lead-in rate. And that's what you're going to see where the cruise starts at. Just for an example, $600 a person, maybe for a 7-night cruise. So that might be your starting price. And that's what you'll see advertised. And often that is the price that would be for the lowest interior cabin price. So now we're getting into cabins a little bit, but that is your lead-in rate. And now you can go through and see what is the pricing for a balcony cabin as well, an ocean view cabin, a suite. It really depends on what type of experience that you want. But there's that aspect of the planning for the cabin itself and the budget that is really going to play a large part. And something else that you'll want to consider is sometimes some of the cruise lines are now packaging their cruises with perks or sort of extra packages on the cruise. And depending on the situation, depending on what you like, you may find that those perks really have a lot of value. To give you an example, Celebrity Cruise Line has been selling their cruises for a little while now with some different perks packages. They call them Sail Your Way. And oftentimes what they are doing is you can add a beverage package or a Wi-Fi package on to your cruise for a very reasonable amount. So if those are things you'd like to take advantage of, definitely look at both of those pricing structures. And Princess Cruises is also doing a form of that kind of perks add-on to their cruises as well now. And other cruise lines are doing that too, and they do sometimes have promotions that they have. So definitely always look at the lead-in rate, but don't stop there. Do price out those extra perks that are sometimes coming included with a cruise price that might look a little bit higher, but that is really a little tip to get the most value out of your cruise and possibly save more on your cruise budget overall at the end of the day. Number five, something to mention as well is that if you do have anybody in the family that has special needs, or if you have dietary restrictions, cruise lines are actually wonderful at handling those things and really helping you out with those things. So do mention that to the cruise line or to your travel agent. And then this way, you could really work that out within your booking and make sure that you're choosing really the best itinerary for you, but also that you do let the cruise line know so that they can help to accommodate your needs. And they definitely, on the most part, really, really can. Number six, it's time to plan how you're going to get to your cruise ship. So if you are choosing a cruise that's maybe close to home and you can drive, then that's something that you can do. And you can actually park on site of the different cruise ports. They do have parking available. And in some cases, there are actually lots available at some of the hotels where there are park and cruise rates and things like that. We actually usually just park at the lot for convenience for when we are driving home, but it's completely up to you. There are times that it might be practical to park at a hotel if you've driven in the day before or that kind of thing. But now I'm gonna talk about flights. And just to mention, when you are looking at flights, if you are looking at booking on points, that's something that is really good. But I did wanna draw your attention to Cruise Line Air. Many cruise lines have available Cruise Line Air, and that just means that you're booking your air through their website. It's actually quite easy to do, and many of the cruise lines now have Cruise Line Air that basically is like live pricing, and you can choose your own air itinerary. So I would make sure definitely that you can do that. But when you do that, the advantage is do make sure that you do flexible air, but the advantage, especially if you are booking a few months or even a year before, the advantage is that that air is flexible. And that just means that if you do end up canceling your cruise, or if you do want to make a change to your itinerary, your flight itinerary, that you can actually do so because it is flexible. And what we've seen, especially recently, is, which I think is really a nice advantage, is that for people who have had Cruise Line Air booked, if they did have a change in the cruise, if the cruise was canceled, for instance, or if people canceled the cruise, that they were able to have that flexibility and convenience because it was all done through the cruise line. They were able to have that. So I do think that's a really nice advantage. At the same time, cruise lines, on the most part, will guarantee to get you to the cruise or to the next cruise port when you do have cruise line air. So that is a little extra guarantee. Still fly in the day before your cruise, or even a couple days before, because even if the cruise line guarantees to get you to the next port, that still is super inconvenient if you have missed out on a day or two or more of your cruise. So always follow the advice that you've heard before, which is fly in a day or two before the cruise, at least a day. But take a look at cruise line air when you are making the arrangements for your cruise. Number seven, since you are likely going to fly or drive in the day before your cruise, you will want to make some arrangements for a hotel that might be near the cruise port, or in the case of if you're going to visit the city the day before, perhaps New York, you might even want to be right in the city, or you might want to be near a beach if you're in Fort Lauderdale and that kind of thing, or, you know, right in the heart of the city if you are in Barcelona. There are a few different choices, but definitely book your hotel before your cruise, and you can look at a few different options. One of the things that I like to do is find out with the cruise line which hotel they are using for their pre-cruise hotel. Now, you can book this through the cruise line, and generally this is a more expensive option than booking the hotel directly on one of the websites, like an aggregator website or that kind of thing. So generally that is a little bit pricier. However, it does come with an advantage, and oftentimes it will include your transfers. So you might want to price it out and see if it's a good thing for you to do. But if not, by calling the cruise line and finding out what hotels they are using, that does give you an idea of the best hotels in the area that they most recommend. So if you're not really that familiar with the destination, the cruise embarkation destination, that is a good little tip. And of course, on top of that, you can always find out hotel recommendations from some of the different cruise Facebook groups. I'm a super big fan of them, especially something that is particular to your cruise sailing and to your itinerary. And otherwise, Cruise Critic is still a great place to find out some information as well. Number eight. So do make sure that you've looked into your travel insurance, and it's always important to have travel insurance when you cruise. So you'll want to look into your cancellation and interruption insurance and make sure that you have that covered, just to protect your actual vacation investment. Let's face it, we all work hard for our money. So you do want to make sure that that is covered should you have something that impedes you being able to go on the cruise. So some examples of that could be that right before the cruise, somebody that you're going on the trip with breaks their leg or something, and you or they cannot go on the cruise. Things like that actually do happen, and it's not a matter of age. This can just happen to us all, whether we're young, whether we're older, no matter the circumstance. And the second part to make sure that you have is your medical coverage. Having a problem where you need to go see, where you need to go to the hospital or have surgery or even be airlifted in a worst case scenario off a cruise ship can be extremely expensive, thousands of dollars. And we've all heard these horror stories before. So we just want to make sure that we're not in that situation. So do make sure that you've looked into your travel insurance. And, you know, in some cases, this may be on your credit card. However, you do want to make sure that you're adequately covered. Sometimes we're not adequately covered and we don't really know. So do make sure of that. And you might also want to take a look at your work insurance and otherwise at a third party insurance as well. Now, you can get some amount of vacation protection oftentimes through the cruise line, but one thing to note, and I suggest that you, things can change, I suggest that you do look into it, is the medical portion of this is oftentimes just unfortunately not adequate should we need really the kind of emergency medical care that sometimes people need. It can be way beyond the coverage of that cruise vacation protection. So please do make sure that you're well covered before your cruise. It's definitely well worth it. Number nine, One of the most exciting parts of a cruise is actually the travel experience. So actually what you're gonna do in your cruise ports. So planning your shore excursions is something that you'll wanna do as your cruise gets a little closer. And that can be a lot of fun to look into your shore excursions. So I do have some suggestions. Firstly, a good place to start when you are researching your shore excursions is actually just on the cruise line website. The cruise line website is going to have, the cruise port is gonna have several different options for what you can do. So it might have the tourist highlights, that kind of thing, but it'll also have some off the beaten path, maybe some food tours, just a few different options. But that will give you an idea of the 10 or so favorite things to do in that area. From there, you can actually go on and you can research if you can do things on your own. Some cruise ports are really easy to do so. Or if you might want to book a local excursion. So those are all different options. But the first thing I would do is start with the cruise line. Generally, this will be a little bit more expensive than booking on your own with a local excursion, and especially with doing it on your own. But there are cases where you'll really want to book it with the cruise line, especially if it's a whole long day tour. And there are other times if you're taking a taxi over to a local beach that it could be quite safe to do that on your own. Now, I do have a blog post all about the do's and don'ts and shore excursions. So I will leave that post down below just so you can get some extra tips when you are planning your shore excursions. Number 10. Now, I hope that so far this information has been helpful, but I know sometimes people say, well, it seems a little complicated. Should I be using a travel agent? And what would the advantage be of doing that versus the cruise line itself? So you can certainly book with the cruise line, and there's a lot of details to go through, but you can do that. And cruise lines actually do make it pretty easy for you. However, if you want to have an easier time with all of those different choices and that kind of thing, by using a travel agent, either in person, online, or over the telephone, either a large conglomerate or even a smaller travel agency that deals specifically and with a lot of experience in cruise lines, the advantage is that you do have somebody who has experience that is guiding you through this so that you don't have to make all of the decisions about your specific itinerary or your ship all by yourself. So that is kind of helpful. And oftentimes travel agents, again, that specialize in cruises, know the ins and outs of the different cruise ships, which cruise ships have been recently refurbished, which cruise ships, maybe their clients have had really good recent experiences with. So that kind of experience could just be really, really valuable. At the same time, often, travel agents will be able to give you an extra perk or an extra amenity, such as an onboard credit. And just to let you know, an onboard cash credit, you can usually use that for almost anything on board, from buying something in the gift shops to a specialty dinner to using it to buy drinks and anything else. So that was just a last point about if it does seem a little bit complicated, especially for a first cruise, you may want to work with a travel agent that is very experienced. So I hope that these tips have been helpful to you as you plan your first cruise. If you have comments, if you have questions, please leave them down below. I may do a follow-up video to this to clarify some points. So let me know if there is something that you need a little bit more information about, because I do really want to be able to help with that. So once again, if you did like this video, please give it a thumbs up. I really do appreciate it. And it lets me know that you liked it, but it also kind of helps to grow my channel, which I really do appreciate as well. And of course, if you liked this content and you want to see more content like this, then please consider subscribing to the channel. Now, I am on Facebook and I am on Instagram at Life While Cruised, and I would love to connect with you there. Happy cruising, and until next time.